All right, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to try to figure out how to compute XOR as instead of a single perceptron, which we know is impossible, we can do it as a network of perceptron. And just to make it easier for you, here's how we're going to set it up, that we've got X1 and X2 as our inputs. We've got two units. This first unit is just going to compute an AND, and we already know how to do that. We've already figured out what weights need to be here and here and what the threshold needs to be so that the output will be the AND of those two inputs. So that's all good. But what we don't know, what it turns out to be the case, that the second unit with now three inputs, X1, X2, and the AND of X1 and X2, can also be made to, or can be now we can set the weights on that so that the output is going to be XOR. So what we'd like you to do is figure out how to do that. How do you set this weight that is the input of X1, this weight, which is the AND input, and this weight, which is the X2 input, and the threshold, so that it's going to actually compute an XOR. And just so you know, this is not a trick question. You really can do it this time.